Hi viewers, in this video I will show you how I disassembled some integrated parking brake calipers and also how rusty components can cause caliper pistons to seize up.
In this presentation I used a seized parking brake calipers that came from a Hyundai Accent and a Kia Rio. I considered that some components of these floating calipers were not good enough to rebuild them. These calipers were partially seized due to rust buildup inside the cylinder and on the brake piston. To better describe the disassembly procedure, I also utilized another caliper body to show the interior of the cylinder. To prepare this one, I used vinegar as rust remover and I let it soak for about 1 week. Then I cleaned it, disassembled it, and partially cut it to obtain this result. Normally, the piston is rotated clockwise to insert it and seat it in the cylinder. In this case, I turned it counterclockwise to extract it. When the piston was halfway out, I moved this portion of the boot out of the slot. Then, I was able to quickly confirm that some inner surfaces were degraded by rust. When the piston was disengaged, I removed it. The other caliper assemblies were also damaged by corrosion. This piston boot was easy to remove from this caliper, but the other piston boots were difficult to remove. Under specific conditions, the rust can expand up to 6 times the volume of cast iron. So, after a while, the rust can accumulate in cylinder grooves. When it happens, the seals are compressed against the inner surfaces and the piston can seize inside the cylinder. Normally, with a pick tool, a piston seal is easy to grab from the cylinder. Also, if rust particles and contaminants are present in the brake fluid, they could reach the ABS module and damage it. Other problems like chipping of the piston plating and degradation of cylinder coating can create fluid leaks. Next, I unfastened the snap ring with my modified double joint pliers. This is the return spring retainer. The return spring exerts a constant pressure on the sleeve nut. The washer under the sleeve nut is engineered to sit on the roller bearing. The actuator shaft is built with oval recesses that sit on 3 bearing balls. The ball racer cup is also made with oval recesses to hold the bearing balls. When partially rotated, the balls roll out of the recesses to push the actuator shaft and the adjuster sleeve nut against the piston. Then the parking brake is engaged. The O-ring is used to seal the space between the caliper body and the actuator shaft. There is also another rubber seal on the outer end of the cylinder. The bushing is used to minimize the friction between the actuator shaft and the caliper body. This type of piston is also built with internal parts: a snap ring, a spring, an adjusting bolt, a washer, and a bearing assembly. There was no rust in this piston, but I had another one that was rusty and contaminated. This is an overview of the caliper parts that I disassembled and aligned.
Over the years, I noticed that some rebuilt brake calipers lasted less time than new ones. So that's why now I prefer to install new ones.